What is up, YouTube? It's your... Dang, boy, this light is just so hot. It's your boy, Keep Nation, and we back at it again with another video. Now, if I do not be able to edit both of these videos, that means I will have the same shirt on in two videos. Reason being, I just got done recording my PlayStation. Y'all don't believe me? Look. Y'all see it? Okay, so don't be trying to play me like the boy Keek be having the same shirt on in multiple videos. Don't do that, okay? I just got done recording it. It's the same day, like 5 minutes later, okay? That's all that happened. I take the little, okay? We don't need to go into all that, but look. Okay, hopefully the green, come on now. God damn. Okay, here we go. Okay, so hopefully the green screen working, all that stuff. Now, you guys clicking this video for a reason, a very set for strict reason. You guys want to know how you guys can hit the top 1,000 in Showdown. Now, each 2 weeks, I think it is, for Showdown, you guys will be able to hit the top 1,000, and you guys will be rewarded a free 96 overall platinum card. If you get the top 500, you get a 97. If you get the top 250, you get a 98, and if you get the top... I think if you get the top spot, or number one, you get a 99 overall card. Now, those cards do sell for a lot. The regular Platinum sells for like 2.5 mil right in a day, and then they go up to about 4 mil a couple of days. So, that's basically essentially 4 mil and essentially a free Platinum card just from grinding your butts off. Now, I'm going to tell you guys everything you need to know about how to win Showdown, how to grind Showdown, and how to hit the top 1,000. First thing is first. You gotta learn whether you wanna have the switch defense on or off. Personally, I could do with both on or off. The reason I would say off is because when they throw it to the center, and let's say they throw it inside, it will automatically switch to who that person is guarding. So if they throw it from the point guard to the center inside, you would have to manually switch. And sometimes you're not quick enough to do that. Rather than when it's auto switch on, they will throw it in and you will already be the center, which you could then be swiping up going for the block. So you gotta decide how quick you are, how good you can do that, and that has to be the decision that you make. Now, I'm looking glowing right now. Thumbnail. That's gonna be stuff for the thumbnail. But getting back to the point, so you guys gotta choose whether you want the defensive settings on or off. The auto switch. There we go. Okay. And bam! The second thing you guys need to do. This is very, very important thing, man. You guys need to get you a high rebound rating center. I'm gonna tell you guys straight off the bat, you guys can have a 99 overall center. If his rebounds are below a 90, or you guys do not max him out and his rebounds are not above a 90, he's going to be useless. Fact. Because once you get to superstar and they have those, they Dwight Howards and Mutombos and Embiids and Wilt and all those guys, and you guys don't have a center with a 90 plus rebound rating, you're going to get demolished. Destroyed, beat up, and frustrated because EA, they be wanting to let the other team grab 14 rebounds before you can even decide to want to grab the ball. You don't want that to happen. Are you a race like me? Don't let this happen to you. Look at me. Don't let this happen to you. Get you a good center. Get a good center with a high rebound rating. Get a good, a above average power forward, an 85 plus rebound rating, and you're going to be sent. Third thing you guys want to do, this is a very great tip. I highly recommend it. Auto play defense. We don't need to play defense because if you notice, the AI plays perfect defense on himself. It's itself. The AI versus the AI. Let that be that. You reaching, that's not, once you get past superstar, difficulty, that's not going to work out. I'm telling you, once you get past superstar one, that reaching, you're not going to get the ball. Maybe pro through all-star three, you're going to be able to reach for it still and get it. But once you get to superstar, it's going to happen less and less. They're going to do step back to your face, and they're going to score every single time. Stop that. Auto play defense. Say enough said. No need to explain. The computer plays better defense than you do. Yes, they do. You think you play better defense, but you don't. The AI plays great, perfect. Bon Appetit defense, plus the 90 center, plus the switching. If you guys want to play defense from pro to all-star, you're going to be set. That's mainly defensive thing. Now, offensively. Okay, guys, offensively. I'm talking really fast because I want to get this video through. I don't want to be talking for too long. This is a 4-minute video already. Okay, here we go. So, offensively, you guys want to balance your shot threes and shot twos. If you're on a lane and you have a wide open lane, take the dunk. You guys have a player like Ben Simmons, a LeBron James, a Russell Westbrook, a Dwayne Wade, a Giannis Antetokounmpo, a Kawhi Leonard, one of those high dunk rating dudes, and you guys are, let's say it's 8-8, and you guys need a guaranteed bucket, take the two-pointer, man. Take the two-pointer. Just dunk it. Just dunk it. I'm telling you, it will help you guys out. We get a lot of points. Just dunk it. Dunk it. Okay, so that's the final balance. I'm going to link my video on how to never win a head-to-head. Use some of those tips in there on scoring. It's a little thing that I used to do, like back and forth, where you guys hit a lot of threes. I'm going to link my how to make every three-point shot, too, so you guys can do that. That's what I used to make a lot of threes. Do that. That will work for you. Now, the only other thing I can think about is, load up on your stamina. Load up on your stamina. So there's a stamina live event. I will pop it up somewhere right now. Boop, pop it up. There's a live event, live stamina live event. Do that and make sure you guys do your daily objectives. Do the daily objectives. You get 50 more stamina for that. Now, make sure you don't waste more stamina doing the daily objectives than you would get for the daily objectives. So let's say it says, like, do a daily shoot around, make two shots in showdown, buy a pack, and train a player. Do that, because then that's essentially free 50 stamina. If it's like use 100 stamina, play these two live events, don't do that, because then you're going to waste stamina that you could be using for the showdown. Understood? Cool. Now, last but not least, the last thing I could think of is get some boost, man. Get some boost to your team. Fill your team with some nice bench. You shouldn't have a great starting lineup and a terrible bench. Go get some 92 overall cards. Fill them with your bench. Match them out. That way, your team overall will be better. And when you happen to the match, you will have that boost. I'm telling you, it works. It's very good. It's very helpful to start off with the ball and get the first point. You get this little +2, +15, whatever it is, boost from having a high overall lineup that will help you. Now, if you guys want to learn how to be successful, no money spent, I will recommend you to my boy Ultimate Buckeye. He does great with no money spent. He will show you guys how to get great accounts with no money spent. I'm more of a coin guy. I think I'm gonna have a coin making method coming out soon. But yes, these are the tips that you guys need to go back over it. Auto play or auto switch defense. Gotta choose which one. You gotta press auto play defense after you get to superstar. Besides from that, make sure you limit your threes and try to take more twos. If you have three point shooters and a lot of dunkers, take more threes and twos. It depends on your team. Lastly, make sure you guys get some boost and make sure you guys load up on stamina. This is the most important tip. I almost forgot this. Start showdown grind day one. This will get you this. If you guys start showdown day one when it refreshes that day, so let's say it's Sunday morning, Monday morning, if you guys start Monday morning and use all your stamina on showdown and you guys win 10 out of 11 games, you're going to automatically be top 1,000. Now, all you have to do for the next 2 weeks is just maintain around the area. So play around 15, 20 showdown games a day. Maintain that. You should check on every single day for a week straight. Where you just maintain that. You should be, let's say you hit 950. You should stay around 900 to 1,000. Maybe even move into the 800. You want to stay around there. Start off early. That's going to be the best time because everybody's just starting out. That's the best time to get into the top 1,000s rather than later. So what I did last week, if you guys didn't see my streams, I started off showdown very late. And I ended up getting 1,600, something like that, 1,365. And if I started early, I would hit top 1,000. Because at the end, I started losing and I started not picking up enough dubs. But if I started early, I wouldn't have been just trying to get in. I would have already been in. So, that's it. An 8-minute video. I hope you guys liked it. This is The Flash. I'm going to go watch The Flash. Actually, I'm about to go watch Scandal. I like that show. But, hey, until next time, hit that subscribe button. If I didn't put a subscribe thing right here, ignore the fact that I just did that. Until next time, y'all, we out. All I wanna do is go out trapping with the shoes. All I wanna do is go out trapping with the shoes. Wrist game froze, you should see the way we do it. Sexy little bitch, you throwing titties at the window. You from out of town, but you know what we get into. Trapping with shooters. Wrist on froze, you should see how I maneuver. Shorty say she diving up and flex with all the shooters. Shorty, all you gotta get ahead of all my shooters. Oh.